Hello everyone, this is Dr. Crosso here today, and today we are back for more Five Nights at Freddy's 2. The last time we pretty much just failed at night 5, that's all we did. So, we'll be concentrating super hard to not fail again. We need to... This thing is vital. It is also vital that the mask is thrown. Actually, I'm not entirely sure that's extremely vital. It's actually probably not as vital as I think, because I managed to get past the other two... the other three or four times it happened. So it's just a matter of being quick enough. So speed is definitely something you need in this game. Speed as well as concentration. Old Bonnie's coming. Balloon boy. Okay, he's gone. This needs to be wound up like crazy. There we go. Things go all good. All good. All quiet on the Western Front. I think that's a reference to something, I'm not sure. I think that's a book title. I think so. I'm not sure. I think actually flashing that light so often is actually slowing old Bonnie down, because he hasn't come into my office yet. Watch, I say that, and then he'll be in right now. No? Oh, Toy Bonnie is, though. Hi. How are you? Do you want to talk about your feelings? Your murderous feelings. Alright. That was Mangle, in case you guys were wondering. I'm sure you guys know that, though, if you're watching these videos, because you probably already know a lot about Five Nights at Freddy's if you're watching these videos. But then again, I don't know. I can't assume things like that, so... There you go. There's your info. On that. Whenever you hear something that sounds like radio static, that's... That's Mangle in the vent. Which means you need to open the vent, and that means that you need to do the music box. And I'm gonna be dead, because that music box is gonna run out. And then the meh puppet marionette thing, whatever its name is gonna try to eat me. That's basically how things work. That's how life works as a night guard. Don't believe me, try being a night guard yourself. Go check Jesus or something. And you'll find the experience is much the same. I'm sure. This game is completely accurate to life. I think... Whoa. Excuse me? I think I heard something else there. I think I'm just hearing things. Whoa, I'm dead. Okay. Yeah! There we go. This game is stress-inducing. But I must beat it. I have to. I can do this. Calm breaths. Calm thoughts. We can do this together. I think it'd be cool if there was a multiplayer 5 Nights at Freddy's. Yeah, that's what 5 Nights at Freddy's 4 will be. Maybe there will be a multiplayer function. Not sure what much you do. You could have a multiplayer function if there were like a lot more entrances to cover. I could see how that would work. I could also see how that would be very panicked. Definitely require constant and accurate communication.
Hello.
Hello. No! I doofed hard. You know what? It's not even worth it. Loon boy! You're such annoying. Yep. I saw Balloon Boy there, but I flipped up the camera too soon. I was like, oh wait, Balloon Boy was there. Oh wait, my cameras are up. Well, crap. Now he's in my office. And now I'm dead. Balloon Boy doesn't actually kill you though. He just makes a lot of noise, and then Foxy comes. Because Foxy's attracted to noise. For some reason. Actually, all of the animatronics are attracted to noise. But, Balloon Boy also prevents you from using your flashlight. So not only do all the animatronics become a lot more active when Balloon Boy's in your office, you can't use the flashlight to ward off Foxy. So Foxy comes. That's how it works.
Hello.
That's how the game logic works. And that's how life works. I'm gonna stop talking now. So I won't distract myself. And yeah.
Hello.
Wasn't Foxy there just a second ago? He's never left that quickly before. Oh, Toy Freddy, you're getting closer. That's reassuring. Please don't. I'd rather you didn't. Is that him leaving? That's him leaving. And thankfully, Toy Freddy also left as well. Old Bonnie didn't, though. I doofed there. No. Doofed there. Yep, I doofed there. Well then, this is off to a great start. This night. This game is so hard. Why are you hiding? I much appreciate that sass. Oh, what was that? I done goofed. Oh, I've done goofed. Yep. I need to be quicker. All right, then, let's continue. I really wish the cameras in these first two games would be used a lot more. Hi. But with the first game, the only camera you actually needed to check was Pirate Cove. And in this game, the only camera that you actually need to check is the prize quarter for that darn music box. But I do know in the third game, you use the cameras a lot more. Because you've got the audio cues you're supposed to lead Screen Trap around with, and you actually like use the map. Because there's like an audio cue at each location. Depending on where Screen Trap is, you need to cue different audio cues and stuff. So yeah. Once I'm done with this game, I'll be excited to get to the third game, because I know I'll be using the cameras a lot more. So that'll be exciting. Because the cameras were supposed to be like this new thing that's never been done before. And then they barely got used. So I don't really think the camera mechanic got used to its full potential until the third game. It's just some thoughts. Thoughts from a dead man, because I'm dead now. Try this 2 more times, and then we'll end out the episode. I don't need to throw down my mask then. That's okay. Balloon boy is there. That's the sound of him leaving, right? Okay, so you gotta listen to the noises. The noises, just as they are important in the first game, they're important in this game as well. Because, especially when you have your mask down, because when you hear the vent thumping again, then you know they've left. Nuggets. All right, then. Don't do that. I really hate that the signal interrupted sound is the same sound as the one when they're scanning you. Because then, like, signal interrupts and you think that someone's trying to scan you and you're like, oh no, I need to throw on my mask. Gone. Is that Toy Freddy? I didn't see. That was a Freddy of some sort. No! Oh. It was going so well, too. Oh, whatever. Hi! Did Chica seriously not jump scare me when I didn't have my mask on? How did that happen? Did I just find a cheat to where the mask doesn't actually matter? If I did, that'd be amazing. Give life. Oh no, I know this one. It's where you put the things on their heads. Yep. I was getting slower. It startled me. Well, we're gonna have to test that theory about whether or not I actually found a cheat to the game. Next time. So that is all for this time. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and subscribe and tell me down in the comments what you want to see me do or play next time. And I'll see you next time. Goodbye!